Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making my version of Lynn's BLT home fries. And that inspiration comes from our visit to Lynn's Paradise Café in Louisville, Kentucky. Now, we referred to those home fries as loaded home fries in some previous videos, but the actual name, I think, is BLT home fries. And I have the ingredients. I can't say they're in the right amounts, and I may change up the placement of them on the dish, but it will give you an idea. And if you're interested, get on the internet and search for Lynn's Paradise Cafe, and also search for BLT home fries, and you might find a recipe for it. But let's go ahead with ours. The upload before last, I did home fries, and those were kind of in the method that Lynn had used on her home fries. So we've got a strip on an oven-proof dish down the center that we can top, and that will make them loaded. So we're going to use spinach. This is washed and in leaf form, and I'll just place it on here so that we get pretty good coverage. We've cut out the inner stem because that's kind of tough and unwieldy to eat in a dish like this. So we're just covering. I really like spinach myself, and I like it raw like this, but it's going to get a little heat because, and I mean, it's going to get warm because we're putting it in the oven. So about like that, which is not a whole lot, but it pretty much covers up our fries. Actually, I'd like to see a little fries around the edges. And you know, I was using two potatoes, and we did a little bit of taste testing on our previous two videos, but I would like to see more potatoes here because ours was a big serving, heaped up, and I don't want to minimize it by doing something that is much less. Now, two toppings that were on there were chopped tomatoes and chopped purple onion. And as I recall, on one side we had the purple onion, and on the other side we had the tomato. That was great, but the way we eat around here, if we share this, we don't want one of us getting the purple onion and the other one getting the tomato. So I'm going to use the tomato and just put it all along. This is 1/4 cup. And with the spinach, just use as much as you feel like you would want. And if you don't like spinach, you don't have to put it on there. That's the way I look at all the recipes. So, Lynn, if you happen to see this, forgive me for changing your recipe. But I think recipes are just to share with people and to let them give their own take on it sometimes. And I'm doing the same thing with the purple onion. And I don't think I'm going to need the whole 1/4 cup. I'd say more, maybe 1/8 cup, because I'm leaving half of this behind. I don't want it to be really wild with onion. But again, if you love onions, then put maybe 1/4 cup. Miss the end a little bit down there. And then something else that was on these BLT, you know, that's bacon, lettuce, and tomato. It wasn't lettuce, it was spinach. But the B is the bacon. So I think I'll cut it, excuse me, Rick. I'll cut it with scissors here so I'll be able to sprinkle it. It would be kind of hard cutting it over the top. And this is bacon like I keep in my freezer all the time. Try to keep 1 pound or 2 cooked up that is partially done, and then I stick it in the microwave to crisp it up. So this is really crispy. And that's the way I would like it because I don't want to create a lot of bacon grease on the top of this. So go the full length, putting your crisp bacon pieces. That looks pretty good. And there's one more thing it needs before it goes in the oven. And you see, it is getting to be a pretty big package here. So I think I could probably almost do for lunch on half of it, and Rick on the other half. Although he's already commented that he wished there had been twice as many potatoes here. Now, I've got 1/2 cup of Monterey Jack cheese. It's shredded fine. And the reason I wanted to shred it finely is that with it going in the oven, I'd like for this to melt very quickly, and I don't want to have strings of cheese that have not been melted. But with it fine grated like that, I believe it will melt down nicely. Now I want you to know that after this is heated and all of those flavors are blended, it will get this final touch, which is a dressing. It's the sour cream horseradish dressing that we uploaded previously. So I'm going to a 400 degree oven, and I'm going to let this stay at 400 degrees until I feel like it's heated through. Then I'll turn it to broil and round off the top and bring it back and let you see it. We just got our BLT home fries out of the oven, and I want to tell you, I let them stay for 5 minutes at 400 degrees, and the cheese was all melty, and they were beginning to brown a little on the top, but I turned it to broil for 2 minutes. So you just should watch it very closely, and if it starts getting very brown, you want to get it out of there. The final step in finishing this up is to put your horseradish sour cream dressing. Actually, it's called sour cream horseradish dressing on top, and it could go lengthwise on that, but I think this is going to be prettier if we just put it drizzled across the center. Something like that. Now I want to tell you at this point that this doesn't really look huge. It's only about as half as much as was served to us, and what we got was one half serving. You could get twice as much as this and then doubled again for what they give you at Lynn's Paradise Café. So I don't want to belittle the dish, because I just had two potatoes to work with, and we ate a little bit here and there, and maybe I didn't put as much topping on. I just try to keep it all balanced, but it is a very generous portion at Lynn's Paradise Cafe, so I hope you have a chance to try that sometime. Here we have our finished BLT home fries, or we call them sometimes loaded home fries. And I want to take some out on a plate so you can get the full effect here. And I'll go toward the center. You can see it's nice and crispy and crunchy. So let's get plenty of that sauce. And for Rick and I, I'm looking at the amount that I have here. If I take half of it, well, that would be kind of a small lunch, so probably all of it would be a good sized lunch. But if you should get it at Lynn's Paradise Cafe, expect a lot, because she is very generous with her servings. Okay, let's see how it tastes. I want to get quite a few of those flavors in there, and definitely get a piece of potato and some sauce, and we'll check it out. That sauce really makes it. Potatoes are good. The bacon, nice and crunchy still. I didn't get any of the tomatoes or spinach, so I'm going back for a little bit more. Mmm, warm tomatoes on this. That's the best. I love it. I think you'll like it too.